It was a beautiful day with plenty of sunshine, mostly clear skies across the area right now in our neck of the woods. However, take a look at the map because most of the U.S. is pretty calm. However, we had that nor'easter that moved through that affected places like New York, Pennsylvania, New Jersey. And now it's continuing to move up into the New England area, into Massachusetts, where in Pennsylvania, New York, New Jersey dumped close to 2 feet of snow. And thousands were still without power, outages from Virginia all the way up to Maine. So I cannot imagine 2 feet of snow in the heartland. Well, I think we can handle maybe just a little bit as we're heading into the weekend. As we're heading into the rest of the evening and overnight, we'll start to see just a little bit of increasing cloud cover across the areas, those temperatures continuing to fall. Now, the next little weather maker for our area is going to come in late Saturday night and into very early on Sunday. We'll see those temperatures warming up. However, that system that's going to bring in a little bit of a wintry mix late Saturday night and into Sunday. It'll start off with a little bit of a shower, changing over to a little bit of a wintry mix and some light snow as those temperatures continue to fall below freezing on Saturday night. Right now, looking at less than a half an inch of snow accumulation across southeast Iowa and northeast Missouri. But the Friday setup, we've got a lot of warmer air from the south. It's going to continue to move in and affect us as we're heading into Friday. So we'll start to see a little bit warmer air as we're heading into Friday and into the weekend. Beautiful evening shaping up as we're taking a look at the sky cam in Macon at this hour. Pretty nice out there with clear skies. Temperatures though, 37 degrees at Macon. Winds are out of the west at around 5 miles per hour. So very light winds across the area. In fact, very quiet, calm conditions across southeast Iowa and into northeast Missouri. Temperatures 31 in Ottumwa, Kirksville coming in around 37. Right at the freezing mark in Centerville, we're looking about 32 degrees. So temperatures for tonight not falling, only into the lower 20s. Waking up on a chilly note with partly cloudy skies, still below normal for this time of year. Winds will remain light out of the east at around 5 miles per hour. We're looking at warmer temperatures starting to rebound as we're heading into the weekend. On Friday, TGIF 45 degrees with partly sunny skies. Winds remain on the lighter side, 5 to 10 miles per hour. And here's the 7-day forecast. Take a look at these temperatures. 49 degrees on Saturday with partly sunny skies. Those clouds will start to increase as that little system moving in from the central plains, and that's going to affect us late Saturday night and into Sunday with a chance for a wintry mix and some light snow as those temperatures fall to about 31 degrees, rebounding about 42 on Sunday. So we'll start to see just a little bit of a wintry mix early on Sunday, changing over to some light showers as those temperatures continuing to warm up. 44 degrees on Monday. And John, we are talking 50s once again as we're heading into midweek next week, about 57 on Thursday. Overnight lows into the 20s and 30s. Of course, anytime, check us out 24/7 at KTVO.com. So I guess compared to 2 feet of snow that nor'easter that brought to the New England area, and in fact, they might get another nor'easter on the horizon Sunday, Monday, and into Tuesday, possibly.
We've got it pretty good compared to all that.
We certainly do. My goodness.
We complain about this, but we really shouldn't.
So I think a half an inch, yeah. I think we can deal with.
We certainly can. Thanks, Teresa. Coming up next in